What's up, YouTube? So have you ever had the issue where your Wi-Fi gets grayed out? This happens a lot on the iPhone 4 and 4S especially. I'm going to show you guys how to fix it. Just to let you know, I've actually fixed this device a couple times and it works for a while and then it just happens again. So what you're going to need to do is you need a heat source. We actually need to heat this device up. It's actually kind of is the same thing you see done with like Xbox 360s when they give you the red ring of death, or PlayStations when they give you the yellow light. You got to heat up the board. So the board is where your SIM tray is located. There is a circuit board here and here. We need to heat up a chip right in here to a certain point so that the connections will be good again and it'll work for a while longer. So it'll gray out here. It grays out kind of basically all across the OS. You won't be able to use Wi-Fi. So I'll show you guys how to fix that. Alright, so I don't have a heat gun here. The best solution would be to take the two screws out here, take this off, and hit this with a heat gun when the device is off. But I'm actually going to show you guys a technique that most of you will be able to do. You can find at home a source of heat that you can use. I'm going to use an electric fireplace. Now, just to say, these have lithium batteries in them. They're very unstable, so it's if you already have a bad battery or a bloating battery or something like that, I do not recommend doing this. Before you begin, just know this is on you, so don't complain if like this could cause a house fire, so just be very careful. I'm actually going to take this device and I'm going to heat it right up. So it's already getting heated up, it's getting blasted from the heat here, but I'm just going to allow it to sit bored down in the little slit right here, and we're just going to heat it up. So optimally, you'll want to wait for the warning screen that should come up and say your device is too hot to operate. That's how you know you've left it long enough. I would say maybe 10 minutes or so. Keep an eye on the device. Don't just leave it and walk away. Make sure you're checking it. You're checking the state of the device, and just be very cautious when you're heating these up, especially with the battery in it. Like I said, the best solution would be to remove the battery and heat the board up on its own, just eliminating the possible effects of the battery if anything were to happen. So we're just going to let this heat up and we'll be back real soon. Alright guys, so this is what I'm looking for. See how it needs to cool down? That's what you need to get your device to do. So now what we're going to do is we're going to just let the device cool. We're going to turn it off, so power the device down, and just turn it off, and just let it sit, and let it cool down, okay? So you don't have to like fast cool it with a fridge or anything. I wouldn't suggest that because of the condensation. The device is a little warm. So just let this device cool. So I'm just going to let it sit. Alright guys, so it's been about 10-15 minutes or so. I put the device outside. It's pretty chilly here, so I was able to cool the device right back down. And we're going to turn it on and see if our Wi-Fi works. So hopefully this trick works. It's worked for me before. And hopefully it works for you guys watching this video and brings some life back to your device. Again, this is an iPhone 4S, as you can see there. And we're almost booted. Alright, go in and unlock the device, head into settings, head into Wi-Fi, and there you go, my Wi-Fi is working again. So there you guys have it. It's now 4 p.m. If you look back in the video, I started about 3:45 to 3:50, and yeah, my Wi-Fi is finally functioning again. So hopefully this fixes it for you guys, as it fixed it for me here. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel for more, and we'll see you next time.